much love that I was into, but I consistently took it from those who would give it, and I never gave it back. You could call it a strong arm robbery, a heist of the heart, because back then, it was all about how many I could swindle into giving me their love. I was the man, and they knew it too. You couldn't tell me anything, and even if you did, I wouldn't listen because I was caught up in the hype of me. I was the type that they loved to see, you know, light skin, wavy hair, nice teeth. I bought into their false perception of perfection, but in turn, I sold them lies. I was that wooden nickel that could pass for a silver dollar because the flesh hid my imperfection so well. So what if I wasn't the very thing I was supposed to be? Because out of all the other options, there was no one close to me. Or at least I thought. But don't you dare judge me, since you don't know what it's like to be me. Or maybe you do. But it doesn't matter. But as a matter of fact, it does, because you need to hear this too. See, I thought my love was the end-all, be-all, you know, like the Alpha and Omega. As if I had created it from my own rib, performing surgery like Ben Carson with my gifted hands, giving no anesthesia and no room for recovery. I took that love. I played with it. I dated it, even had my way with it. Examined it like a specimen, foreign to my comprehension, but I never knew what it really meant. And that was the problem. I was a lover that didn't know love. I couldn't show love because I was never taught, with no clear model to follow. I blazed my own trail. And my destination went from love to lust. And with a single thrust, I was pushed to the point of no return, but it felt so good that I just went with it. But it wasn't until I heard his voice speak love to my soul that I was able to fathom what it was to me. You see, I always thought that love was shaped like a heart, but I had an encounter that blew my mind. Because if hearts were meant to be broken, why would I attach love to it? That's the question that I had to answer, and I found the solution to my problem when I realized that it was all simple math. No multiplication along division, just addition, as that plus sign began to take on a new definition, no longer with numbers attached to me, but now my savior was hanging from it. I found it in the cross. With every nail that was driven in his hands and feet, love was proven. With every thorn that ripped his flesh on his brow, love was shown. When he spoke forgiveness for the ones that handed him over, love was declared. Do you see what I mean? Love for me was no longer shaped like a heart, but it was now shaped like a cross. Love for me was found in the cross of Christ. So instead of drawing hearts on the love letters that I sent to my wife, I will now draw crosses to show her that my love will never die. I'm a lover, and my problem has been solved now that the lover of my soul has taken over.